boys and girls and moms and dads. I wanted to share a book with you today for Jesus time. Sometimes I like to read different books that help us remember the lessons. This is a book that I just bought for our family, and I wanted to share it with you too. I think it's a wonderful book for talking about the Easter story. It's called Easter Love Letters from God, and it's really cool because on the inside there are parts to the Easter story. It talks about all the different parts of it, and on many of the pages you find a little love letter from God. Okay, boys and girls, you might remember from school that at Valentine's time we talked about our love letter from God, and that was the Bible, right? Well, there are some words from God's word in here. I would just say that one thing I didn't like about this book so much is that it doesn't really focus on why Jesus had to do all of these things. So it talks about, you know, the ride into Jerusalem and the gloomy garden where Jesus was arrested and Jesus dying on the cross and in the tomb, and then coming back alive again, but it doesn't really talk about why that all needed to happen. So as I read through it today, I'm going to reiterate why Jesus had to do those things, because we sin, and we can't get away from that problem. We are stuck with that problem every minute of every day, but that's why he came. So with that in mind, I'm going to read just a couple of pages out of this book today to review our story of Jesus dying on the cross. All right, I will read some words and then I'll share the picture with you, okay? All right, so here we have a picture of Jesus in the garden. You know, we heard about him praying there and he was arrested there. Do you see the soldiers coming to arrest Jesus? Okay, now we'll get to a story called The Darkest Day. High on a hillside, Jesus hung on the cross. I'll just show you the picture. See that picture there? Jesus hung on that middle cross. Long, sharp nails pinned him to the wood. A crown of spiky thorns dug deep into his forehead. Jesus was ready to die. He could see his mother crying. He could hear the soldiers laughing at him. He could feel the sharp nails through his hands and his feet. Jesus cried out. He could not move. He could not breathe. He felt all alone. Where was his father now? The sun disappeared behind a huge gray cloud. Cold crept in. Darkness covered the world. Jesus closed his eyes. He bowed his head. He took one last breath, and at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, in that cold and darkness, Jesus died. Show you the picture from this page. See that? The wind howled. The whole earth trembled. The rocks shattered. The hills quaked, and the mighty temple curtain split in two. But Jesus was still. It was finished. We hear some words from God's word from Romans. Here are some memory treasures for us. It says, nothing at all can ever separate us from God's love. Let's read this little love letter from God in here now, okay? I'll read what it says. It says, dear boys and girls, shall I tell you a secret? When Jesus was dying on the cross, I was crying too. When those nails were hurting Jesus, I was hurting too. When Jesus felt all alone, I felt all alone too. And when my son died, part of me died too. But guess what? Death does not win in the story. Life wins. Love wins. My promise to Jesus was that nothing could separate him from my love. And that is the same promise I give to you. Love God. Why did he do that? He did that because we have this sin problem. So Jesus died to take away that sin that separates us from our God. I'm going to move on now. I'm going to read about the quiet cave. Okay, here's a new part of the book that talks about Jesus' burial. Last time we made an Easter hill, and we remembered how he was put in the tomb after he died on the cross. So let's read, and I'll show you the pictures in a little bit again. Jesus had died. Joseph and Nicodemus were sad. They carefully took Jesus' body down from the cross. They cleaned him. They wrapped his body in strips of white linen, and they carried him to a quiet cave on the hillside. They laid Jesus down inside the cave. Then they said goodbye. See this beautiful picture here? See Jesus lying right here, covered by that white cloth. There he is. Before the men left, they rolled a big stone over the entrance. I'm going to show you that picture again. Can you see this man here ready to roll the stone in front of the tomb? Soldiers stood guard too to make sure nobody would move that stone away. Let's keep reading. It says, outside the cave, two guards kept watch. The big, heavy stone was sealed in place, and for 3 whole days, all was still. See those guards guarding the tomb? But inside that cave, God was working. If you tried to peek inside, you couldn't see anything. If you stood outside and put your ear to the big stone, you couldn't hear anything. If you tried to imagine what was happening, you couldn't. You could have no idea what was happening. But inside, God was doing something truly amazing, something only God could do. Jesus waited, and the world held its breath and waited with him. There are some memory treasures in this book to share with this story as well. It says, I am about to do something new. Jesus was doing something new. Let's read his love letter to you. See on this page? It says, your love letter from God. Dear boys and girls, do you like surprises? Inside that quiet cave, I was working on a surprise that no one could imagine. It would be the greatest surprise the world had ever known. Something was happening to Jesus. My son was going to have a brand new life. But for 3 whole days, the world had to wait. Love, God. What is that surprise going to be? I think you might already know. We'll read this story next time. Okay? So yeah, parents, I really enjoy this book. I just, like I said, I want to reiterate why Jesus was put in that tomb, why he died on the cross, why was he put in the tomb, why did he have to rise again on the third day? Because he loves us and he wanted to take our sins away. Boys and girls, don't forget that. He had you in mind when he did all of those things. All right, that's all for now. I will see you next time. Goodbye.